council come to order, please. We do have all of our council and have a quorum here tonight, and it is 7 p.m. And we are in regular session for the Tuesday, September 10th council meeting. In just a moment, I'll ask everyone to stand. We'll be led in an invocation by Pastor Joel Keeley of Bar Church, and followed by that, we'll be led in the pledges to the American flag and the Texas flag by Councilmember Fleury. Please stand.
All right, let's pray. God, thanks for tonight, for the day we had. Let's pray we'd be grateful. Help us to be generous. Bless this meeting. Help us to work hard for the good of one another in the community, remembering the least and the lost and the hurting. And bless our firefighters, police officers, first responders, those that run to trouble when others run from it. Protect them. Thank you for our town. May your blessing be upon it. Through Jesus I pray. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible.
You may be seated. It is time for citizens' presentations. This is an opportunity for citizens to address the council on any matter, whether or not it's posted on the agenda. The council is not permitted to take action on or discuss any presentations made to the council at this time concerning an item that is not listed on the agenda. The council will hear presentations on specific agenda items prior to the council addressing those items. You may speak up to 4 minutes or a time limit determined by the mayor or presiding officer. To speak during this item, you must complete the speaker's form that includes the topics of your statement. Topics of presentation should be limited to matters over which the council has authority. Holly, I don't see that anybody asked to speak.
No, Mayor.
Is there anybody in the audience that wants to speak at this time? All right, seeing no one wishing to do so, we will move on to item number one. Receive interim town manager Carroll's update and provide input regarding the following: Patriot Day ceremony and National Night Out. Yes, Mr. Carroll.
Good evening, Mayor and council members. The Trophy Club Fire Department will be hosting our annual Patriot Day ceremony tomorrow morning at 8:45 at the fire station. We'll be honoring those civilians and first responders that were killed in the attacks on our country in 2001. We ask that everyone please join us for a moment of silence, some remarks from our mayor, and from both Interim Chief Cochran and from Chief Arata as well. So that's tomorrow morning at 8:45. At the fire station. I'd also like to report that this last weekend was our 11th annual Pet Fest event. The event included some pet related vendors, a pet photo booth, a DJ, some face painting, and we provided breakfast. The event was a huge success with 350 people in attendance. A special thank you to our Parks and Recreation staff and the volunteers that made the event an enjoyable morning for all of our citizens and their guests. I'm available for any questions.
Council, anybody have questions of Acting Town Manager Wade?
National Night Out.
Do we have a date on National Night Out?
October 1st.
October 1st. October 1st will be National Night Out. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much. We will all move on to the consent agenda. All matters listed on the consent agenda are considered to be routine by the Town Council and will be enacted by one motion. There will not be a separate discussion of these items. If discussion is desired, that item will be removed from the consent agenda and will be considered separately. Does any member of council wish to remove any of the items 2 through 5?
Motion to approve consent agenda items 2 through 5.
Second.
All right, Councilmember Jensen moved. And Fleury seconded. All in favor, show your hands. It is unanimous, 6-0. It is 7:04 p.m., and we will enter into public hearing. Item 6, conduct a public hearing regarding the proposed fiscal year, October 1, 2019 to September 30, 2020, budget pursuant to Section 9.05 of the Town Charter, making appropriations and providing for expenditures. And And so anyone wishing to speak on this, are you going to talk about this, Wade, first?
I just had an introduction. That was
all right, sir. Good.
Good evening again, Mayor and Council. This item meets the requirements of both state statutes and town ordinance for a single public hearing for our FY 2019-2020 budget. This public hearing, any citizen can come forward and ask questions, and we have our staff present and available for questions.
All right, just as a part of an update for this item, the purpose for fiscal year 2020 budget includes a total ad valorem tax rate of 0.446442 per $100 valuation. The portion of the total tax rate for maintenance and operations is 0.336442 cents per $100 valuation. The portion of the total tax rate dedicated to debt service is 0.11 cents per $100 evaluation. The proposed tax rate is below both the effective tax rate of 0.446997 per $100 evaluation and the rollback rate, which is 0.473065 per $100 evaluation. If you would like to turn to page 109 in your packet, you may read it to yourself silently. The Town of Trophy Club property tax revenue is 61.1% of the total general fund revenues. By maintaining the previous year's tax rate, the town is able to maintain its current service levels. So anybody wishing to ask questions about our proposed fiscal year October 1, 2019 to September 30, 2020 budget? All right, seeing no one wishing to speak, we will move to item 7, which is part of the public hearing. Conduct a public hearing regarding the proposed tax rate for fiscal year October 1, 2019 to September 30th, 2020, and the mayor to announce the date, time, and place of the vote on the tax rate. So, the tax rate, as stated earlier, that's being proposed is 0.446442 per $100 evaluation. And on September the 24th, 2019, at our regular council meeting at 7 p.m., we will be adopting the budget and setting the tax rate. Just to remind everybody that although the tax rate for this coming year is the same as our current year, earlier in this year, we did provide a $5,000 property exemption to our residents, which in effect lowered the amount of taxes you would pay by almost 8 cents. And we did all of that in the last 7 years by lowering our tax rate every year for the last 7 years, except this year, while we even built New Town Hall and provided for the debt service for this building. So anybody wish to speak on this particular item number 7 of the tax rate for the public hearing? Seeing no one seeking the chair, we will then close our public hearing at 7:08 p.m. and reconvene into our regular session. Item number 8, consider and take appropriate action regarding a proclamation of the town council recognizing September 13, 2019 as the 10th anniversary of Barra Church and Trophy Club and providing an effective date. So just a minute, and I'm going to read that. Whereas Joel and Kim Keeley and their family faithfully following God's leading planted Barra Church to be a non-denominational, Bible-believing, God-loving, Spirit-filled community service church on a mission to know Christ and to make him known. And whereas Barra, being the Hebrew word for create, meaning to create something out of nothing, and whereas Barra Church held their first Sunday gathering at Beck Elementary School on September 13, 2009, and whereas Barra Church has enjoyed a great fellowship and relationship with the Town of Trophy Club, and whereas Barra Church has demonstrated a desire to live lives of humility and peace, and whereas Barra Church has sought to strengthen the bonds of community and friendship, and whereas Barra Church has faithfully served our town collectively and our residents individually, and whereas Barra Church has been given a hope and a future that they generously and enjoy share with the town of Trophy Club, and whereas we give pause, honor, and praise this day for the deep and abiding Christian commitment of those who in faith begin this work, and for all those who have given so unselfishly during this past decade to help the church family grow and thrive, providing a valuable contribution to our community. Now therefore, I, Mayor Nick Sanders, in conjunction with the Town Council of the Town of Trophy Club, Texas, do hereby proclaim September the 13th, 2019, as the 10th anniversary of Barra Church and Trophy Club. We extend this expression of our esteem and best wishes to the members of this congregation on this memorial occasion, offering our congratulations and appreciation for 10 years of faithful Christian service and outreach to the Trophy Club community. In light of the needs of our world today, Barra Church's example for the past 10 years, I urge all citizens of Trophy Club to love one another and the pure, peaceful, and powerful love of God. This time I'd entertain a motion to approve the proclamation.
So moved.
Second.
Mayor Pro Tem Jensen moved, seconded by Schaffner. All those in favor, raise your hand. It is unanimous. At this time, I would ask Joel and whoever else he would like to have with him to come up and we'll present you the proclamation. And as you come up, Joel, I just want to say a few words personally when he comes up. For those of you who did not know, I don't think that there is a special event or public event that the Town of Trophy Club has that Barra Church doesn't volunteer to help.
Pet Fest last week. We weren't there. We tried. I mean,
let me just carry that. I can't believe you did that.
He's honest.
Well, except for Pet Fest.
Yeah.
That one time.
What I know is that surely at our 4th of July celebrations, not only participation in the parade, but getting your congregation together early to make breakfast burritos and serving those at our 5K run, and almost every other event we have, your people are there to volunteer and to make us a better community, and it really shows for us. And so there's nothing that we could do to say adequately thank you to you and all of your people who serve unselfishly to make Trophy Club a really great place to live and to worship and to live.
Yeah.
So congratulations to you.
Thank you, Nick. I appreciate that very much. I've got our administrator, Robin Angas, and her husband, Keith, is shooting video, and one of our members, Andy, is with us, and my wife is working late. She would love to be here, and several other people, because Roanoke's doing the same thing right now. So, but this means
you weren't supposed to say that.
Well, that's like already did.
Turn around, face this way. We love that. Let's go back here by the seat.
Yes, sir. Thank you. One more. Thank you guys very much.
It's kind of like standing next to Eric.
I can join if you want, sir.
Jill, I want to make sure you use the right picture for the website. You figure out which one you think you should use. We'll see how that works. Of course, course, it may really look bad. I'm the same height as Joel, but anyway. All right. Item number 9. Consider take appropriate action regarding a proclamation of the Town Council recognizing September 2019 as Suicide Awareness Month in Trophy Club and providing an effective date. So this is Proclamation 2019-20, and the chair would recognize Alicia Fleury to read the proclamation and move it.
Whereas Americans attempt suicide an estimated 1.4 million times annually, and 129 Americans die by suicide each day, with over 20 being our country's veterans, equating to 47,000 deaths by suicide a year. And whereas more than 1.6 million years of life are lost to suicide, and the combined medical and work loss cost in the U.S. is $44 billion per year. And whereas suicide is the 10th leading cause of death in the United States, the second leading cause of death for ages 12 to 44, and the fifth leading cause of death for ages 45 to 54. And whereas more teenagers and young adults die from suicide than from cancer, heart disease, AIDS, birth defects, stroke, pneumonia, influenza, and chronic lung disease combined, and veterans comprise over 14% of suicides. And whereas in the United States, 90% of those who die by suicide had a diagnosable psychiatric disorder at the time of their death. And whereas many of those people who died never received effective behavioral health services for many reasons, including the difficulty of access, the stigma of using behavioral health treatment, and the stigma associated with losing a loved one to suicide. And whereas organizations such as American Foundation for Suicide Prevention, National Institutes of Mental Health, Veterans in Crisis, and Gallant Few provide research, resources, and support in order to spread awareness and prevent suicide. Now, therefore, I, Mayor C. Nick Sanders, in conjunction with the Town Council of the Town of Trophy Club, Texas, do hereby proclaim September 2019 as Suicide Prevention Awareness Month. I move to pass Proclamation 20-19-20 as read.
And I'll second. It has been moved and seconded. Moved by Alicia Fleury, seconded by myself. All in favor, show your hands. It is passed unanimously. Council, we did ask that our newest elected council member, as of this past weekend, who will be sworn in at the last meeting in this month, who organized and executes Gallant Few Charity, I don't know how to say that, is with us today to receive the proclamation. I think you already heard the fact that part of what Gallant Few does is counseling and are to provide resources for military as they try to adjust back into society. And the number of military that take their own life after service, at least service in war, is something that really needs to be addressed. And so on behalf of the council, thank you very much for the work that you do with those people. So I've got that proclamation.
And Carl, you want to speak a little bit about your organization, Gallant Few?
I would, if I could just add something real quick, because almost on a weekly basis, I work one-on-one with veterans who are going through suicidal thoughts. And the biggest thing that I see when they are going through that is the problems that are in front of them are greater than the good that they see in the future. So they're standing in front of a brick wall. They can't see around the brick wall, even though there might be a window 2 feet to the right. And as they face that brick wall and they can't possibly imagine life on the other side of it, they think other people are going to be better off without them. And that urge becomes so great that some of them take their own lives. I have a great uncle of mine that fought in the Korean War that killed himself when he was 80. I have a captain that I served with in the 25th Infantry Division a long time ago that jumped off the Golden Gate Bridge. And it's unfathomable to me that someone could get to that point where they do that. But there are men and women in our community right now that are thinking about it. You know, thank God it doesn't happen very often. But when you look at the numbers that Alicia had read in the proclamation, the VA says 20 veterans commit suicide every day. What you don't read in the news is that 7 out of 10 of those veterans are over the age of 50. It takes a long time for you to lose purpose and hope, for anybody to lose purpose and hope. And when you've lost purpose and you've lost hope, why go on? So We want to be able to interject and get in front of that. And things like the National Night Out that's coming up on October the 1st. It's a wonderful opportunity. If you have someone in your neighborhood that you don't know, reach out to them now. If you have somebody that you kind of know but you haven't seen in a while, go knock on their door. Talk to them. Because you don't know what's going on. And if they're standing facing that brick wall, you might be able to pull them out of it. So I appreciate the opportunity to say something about it. Thank you.
So let's take a pitch from here. We'll have Buddy. And now over here at the side.
And while they're taking photos, I'd like to remind the parents as well, talk to your kids. All of our schools have an anonymous hotline they can call, and they can voice their concern that they may have about a fellow classmate. And, you know, there's no names involved, and it's a really great program that the schools have in place. It's something we need to talk about, we need to say and address to spread awareness and to help others, and just think if you could save one life, it's all worth it. So thank you.
Thank you, Alicia. Item number 10, consider and take appropriate action regarding a resolution accepting an annual service and assessment plan update for authorized services, emergency services, for the Trophy Club Public Improvement District Number 1, the Highlands of Trophy Club, and the proposed assessment role, setting a date for public hearing, authorizing the publication of notice, and directing the mailing of notices as required by law, enacting other provisions relating thereto, and providing an effective date. This is resolution 2019-20, and so Acting Town Manager Carroll will introduce this.
Good evening again, Mayor and Council. The item that you have before you is to accept the annual service assessment plan update for emergency services within the PID. That's the Highlands at Trophy Club. And to set the public hearing for our next council meeting on September the 24th. The assessment is for $506,789, which is the PID's portion of the fire department expenditures. And we're available for any questions that you might have on the PID assessment.
Anybody have any questions about that?
I don't have any questions, but I would like to, I privately thanked her, but I would like to publicly thank Jill for the pamphlet, whatever you want to call it, the insert that she developed. I think in prior years we have had several people in the audience who would get up and question why are they getting this, and so it was a very good explanation, so I appreciate it.
She worked very hard with staff, with Cheryl as well, to make sure that was done, so we're very proud of her. I'm proud of them both.
Thanks.
So I'll entertain a motion to approve.
And I'll make a motion to approve resolution 2019-20.
Second it. Do I need? I'll second. Any further discussion? All in favor, show your hands. All opposed, same sign. Wade, are we going to put the one-page flyer that Jill developed in the mail-out?
Yes, sir. It's included in the mail-out.
Okay. Good. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. All right. Anybody have any other questions related to this? All right. If not, we'll go on to item number 11, discussion of items for future agenda to include agenda items for consideration on the September 24th, 2019 council agenda and items from the town council future agenda list. And so, wait a minute. Okay, so one of those items you're going to talk about is drainage. Is that right?
Yes.
Okay, go ahead. I'm sorry.
Good evening, Mayor and Council. A short list of points to be made during this is that, you know, we get regular drainage complaints on a regular basis. A lot of it has to do with street construction, inlets block, things of that nature. And then we've got the much larger situations where we've got the PD 30 and all the acreage it's dealing with, areas that are in floodways, floodplains, streets collapsing. Sheldon, for example, is sinking on us. It's a major point right now that we're taking. Contractor was actually on that one, supposed to start today. He's coming next Monday, going to replace several panels to get the start on that work. But that's really what these issues showing up front are. private just means that it's a lot that has some issues. It's down at the bottom of the hill, and there's really nothing we can do. In a particular situation on this one, the homeowner actually added some storm drains, additional storm drains or subsurface drains that took care of the problem for them. As you can see on the map, the legend, we've listed the specific locations of where the interaction is and what the complaint was and what the resolution currently is. One of the bigger issues that we have with the creek systems that are eroding, which is all natural, not a whole lot we can do there except for maybe stabilize the banks. One of the things we've got working right now is the stormwater master plan, which I did receive back today. I haven't had a chance to read it yet, but they are complete with the first draft, which should be all it takes. That'll give us some ideas what we can do and what we need to do. We're also working with the Texas Water Development Board and their committees in looking into grants and loans and things of that nature. We're sitting pretty good as far as grants are concerned because of our revenue that we're coming up on and the construction, the way it's headed, which is being built out, obviously. There's about $758 million to go out that'll help assess in this. In conjunction with that, we're working and looking into the National 13 stormwater permit, which allows you to work in waters of the U.S. or creek areas with a limitation of 500 feet where you can go in and stabilize as long as you don't pull soil out or put soil back in. For all the drainage issues that we have, we maintain on a regular basis, both the building inspector, myself when I'm out in the field, as well as code compliance. We do regular updates. For example, on the PD-30, that's a weekly inspection. We're out there, it's a weekly inspection, but we're out there twice a week, once to assess and to note, and in the following week, we start over again to go back and confirm that, in fact, that they have taken care of the problem. We're constantly working with all the builders, whether it's single-family residential or commercial, to take care of the same thing. One of the things to keep in mind is the fact that in the last 3 years, is the rainfall events. Our average rainfall is about 33 inches a year. Our average monthly has been in the past up to 2010 to about 2015, 2 inches a month. We were averaging 8 to 11 inches a month in the last 2 years, and we'd get that 3 months in a row, which really increased it. Lake Grapevine was at 16 feet above the norm, and when the lake's getting higher than the town, the water just kind of settles in and we're saturated. Classic example, and I've got videos from several different areas in regards to the Asheville site. There's a floodplain that goes through there, but the homes are not affected by that under normal circumstances. We'll just skip. Oh, there it is, over on the left. That's the area shown. What happens is when the development came in, the low point by the creek that runs through the Hogans, which includes Asheville, is in fact a floodplain. It's identified in blue. It's got the black lines going across it showing the elevations. All the drainage comes from the south west corner and flows north to the lake. With the water and the ground saturated like it was, it just inundated the soil, so there was nothing absorbing. It was going right across the top. What I plan on doing is working with the golf course to see if they can assist us in some manner, because when you look at the direction of the water flow, it's going to come down right on top of that first section of, as the videos have shown, the first section of Asheville, instead of turning or being absorbed into it. One of the interesting points I found with all the videos that I got was the fact that the individual lot design and development requirements for drainage were working. They were wider than norm, where normally we don't notice the swell carrying the water because the water is absorbed in it. You know, some of these were 10 and 15 feet wide, but they carried the swells in the direction that they were designed for. I'm available for questions.
I appreciate you. I think this is the first time that we've had a town-wide map with a legend that really depicted what's going on in each situation, so I appreciate the work that you've done to put that together.
Sure, and this will be a living document as we get the major ones. Like I said, there's many more, but they're usually resolved in a day or two. They'll be added to this, and we'll continue working on it in this manner.
All right, Council, any questions? Tommy, thank you very much.
Good job. Thanks, Tommy.
Thank you.
So that was item A, which is referencing the future agenda list, item number 6. which was to update us and give us discussion about drainage issues. We appreciate the research and what was done for that. All right, Council, calling you to our meeting date of September the 24th, tentative agenda. Does anybody have any changes or questions about that? Seeing no one wishing to speak, then call your attention to the future agenda list. I want to comment about item number 3, discussion of possible action between the town and EDC 4B regarding long-range planning and use of parcel between Breadwinners and Trophy Club Town Hall. Wade, seeing as though we are, at least at our next council meeting, making appointments to EDC 4B, who owns the land that we're talking about between Breadwinners and Town Hall, and that this has been on our list a while to try to have a joint meeting, we probably should start trying to plan for that first EDC meeting. Obviously, there are people that need to be new to that, or might be new to that, to EDC, and it might be a good time to come together and begin some discussions, if you could get that on the books. It takes a while to get those kind of things planned, so I'm just kind of suggesting you do that, and that would allow item 3 to maybe move forward.
Yes, sir.
Anybody else have anything about future agenda? All right. Michael, do you have something or wanted to say something?
Yes, sir. So on item number 7.
Put the microphone close as you talk.
Closer? Can you hear me now? Okay,
thank
so
you.
On item number 7, I did state that, hey, we talked about looking at a percentage of funds set aside for capital replacement items under a strategic plan. Just wondering if we can have a conversation on that. Is it, do we want to leave just that as a single item? But I do think we need to look at the entire budget as a strategic plan and working with department heads. I know in several conversations kind of leading up to this that we've talked about how that would work, but in preparation of this current budget, but do we need to break that into two, or do we have it, or do we need to correct my current statement of create a strategic plan for the entire budget working with department heads, or do we have a separate item for leaving item number 7 where it is and creating an 8th item for creation of a strategic plan to look at the entire budget and working with all department heads on a path forward?
Just a comment, it surely could be put together, or it could be kept separately. 7 really was specific to capital replacement items, and yeah, that could be a discussion on its own.
It could.
It obviously will have something to do about the budget, mm-hmm, about it. And I really support the idea of expanding and having a strategic plan related to the entire budget. So maybe we either, let's just add an item 8 to do that so that we don't forget the two. To have a develop a strategic plan related to the town budget. Is that,
yes,
a good,
sir,
way to say that?
Yes, sir. And I don't want to get too much into the weeds, but is it okay to say to staff that when it comes to putting together that strategic plan, one of the things I'm really looking for, I think council will be looking for, is like a wish list, like making sure we're taking care of the infrastructure, making sure we're taking care of our assets, making sure that we're taking care of training that needs to happen and taking care of those things we need to take care of by law, and then kind of 4 and 5 as kind of like wish list items for each of the departments. Is that fair to say, or is that getting too much into the weeds?
No, that's fair to say. I think that anytime we look at a strategic plan development, you're going to look at goals and objectives within each department that will be related directly to the budget.
Okay.
All right. Council, anybody else have anything about future agenda or next council meeting agenda? All right. Seeing no one wishing to speak, item number 12, pursuant to the following designated section of the Texas Government Code, annotated Chapter 551, Texas Open Meeting Act, the council will convene into executive session to discuss the following. A, Section 551072, deliberation regarding real property, to discuss deliberation, the purchase, exchange, lease, or value of real property if deliberation in an open meeting would have a detrimental effect on the position of the governmental body in negotiations with a third person. And this is north of State Highway 114, east of Trophy Club Drive, west of the town limits. And item B, Section 551074, personnel matters under subsection 1, to discuss or deliberate the appointment, employment, evaluation, reassignment, duties, discipline, or dismissal of a public officer, the town manager position. It is 7:34. We are in closed session. 8:46 p.m. We will reconvene into regular session. Item number 13, consider and take appropriate action regarding the executive session. Chair will recognize Mayor Pro Tem Jensen for a motion.
Make a motion to authorize Mayor Sanders to finalize negotiations with Steve Norwood to be our next town manager as discussed in executive session.
Second.
Second from Bone. Motion by Mayor Pro Tem Jensen. Any discussion? All right, seeing no one wishing to speak, we'll call a vote. All those in favor, show your hands. All opposed, same sign. Everybody for except Alicia Fleur, who voted against. All right, that concludes our agenda. It is 8:47. We are adjourned.